Oh, hello wonderful people, it's me Monkey. How you doing? I know it's been a while. Right, so here's the story. If you didn't catch yesterday's stream at all, I had a bad year like we all did last year, and it was tough. And to cap it all, my best friend John died in October. And I fell apart, and I kind of wanted, he took his own life, and I kind of wanted to join him. Things got rough, but I found that I couldn't go out like that. I still had fight left in me, you know. So it left me with, well, what do I do? What the frick do I do? I don't have any real skills. No, I do. I have, you know, I'm a skilled musician, but what do I have to offer the world? What? And I've always been creatively unfulfilled. All I've wanted to do all my life is to create stuff, beautiful stuff, to inspire, to, you know, illuminate. And that's all I've got. So this is it. This is it right here. This is the future. We're going to be bringing fun. We're going to be bringing positivity. We're going to be bringing good times, right? And we're going to do it all. We're going to have some fun. And you know, that's what it's about, right? I want to connect with you and tell you that you're great. Right? You don't have to worry about telling me I'm great. I know I'm great. It's fine. I want to tell you you're great. You. I'm looking at you right now. You're great. You are great. You are great. And you know why? Because you're here. And the life has led you to this path right here, right now. Well, that was supposed to be an hour, that. I'm glad I managed to get it out so concisely. That was basically what I wanted to say. The chow on that I've had with trying to get this set up. Yeah, no. But we're here now, right? That's the main thing. The chow on was there, you know, this is the payoff for the chow on. It's a new me, I'm back. Well, it's the old me, it's the original me, it's the me that should have been before my life got bloody derailed, and I'm finally him, you know. It's freaking awesome, and I'm here to spread positivity, joy, and tell you that you're great. That was the gist of it. We're just waiting for Josh, who is eating currently, and he doesn't have to rush. Don't rush, man. I don't want you to have indigestion during the stream, man. That would suck. So take your time, man. I've got this. So this is it. I'm going to be doing this daily, and uploading highlights to YouTube. So, yeah, we're this is it. This is my job. This is what I do. This is what I was born to do. I've been waiting for this moment all my life, literally. Phil Collins, it was all leading to this. The good, the bad, all of it was to lead right here, right now. And I'm blessed to have a platform to say, I want to spread the light, man. I want to spread the truth. I want to be a beacon. I want to spread to the people, right? Positivity, joy. Things aren't all bad, right? They want to tell you that it's all bad, but it's not, right? It's all how you perceive it, man. It's all perception. It's, if you choose to see it one way, then that's how you're gonna see it, and you might be stuck like that forever. But you need to have the mental capacity to say, no, I'm not gonna just adopt one view. I'm gonna be fluid. I'm gonna be dynamic. I'm gonna say, well, there's a million different views. You know, there's a million different views, and you might feel a different way on a different day. You know, but as long as you keep a positive view, life's great. Life is wonderful because you're choosing for it to be wonderful.
You don't awesome. Hi there, chat. Hi there, viewer.
Right, so I don't know what we're going to do.
Right, when I became a black person.
No one knew that I was actually black when I had my white makeup on.
For 6 weeks, two families, my family and a black family, got together in a house in the valley in LA, and we decided to swap races. would go into makeup and become the opposite race. We became black, they became white. Wow. Then we moved in together.
We're talking living together, you know? It's not like, you know, you're gonna see them for a little party, get together, and they go their way and we go our way.
The audio's
at
not
night,
coming out.
We all live under the
same roof. Yeah, it is.
The whole experience, it opened my eyes, just made me more aware of my race.
I'm a pioneer in this because this is something that's never been done.
Changing color to see what it would be like.
It was completely transformative.
We got jobs, went shopping.
Hey, white man.
We would go out together. He's the honky.
We were undercover. We had right. hidden cameras.
I need to say this now. Trigger warning. We're about to get real up in here.
How the world would react to me as a black person. Many times I was shocked.
I feel racist.
We are the Sparks family.
We just a typical black family from Atlanta.
White family here, Vietnamese here, white here, Mexican here. Very diverse, but just like the UN, baby.
Growing up in Michigan as light skin, green eyes, big afro back in the early 70s, it was tough.
I had to fight the darker skinned blacks because I was too light. And then I had to fight the whites because I was too dark. So I had racism from both sides.
I really didn't know what to expect, but I didn't know it was gonna be that intense.
She gonna be crying a lot. She keep with me though. Shit.
I mean, I like it, but it's not something I would wear.
Oh, I thought you liked it.
I would love to sit here and say that everything was just great, but it wasn't.
Oh, you have lost your damn mind.
You can't.
I mean, you wanna know more? You wanna see how this plays out?
Yeah.
Act black.
Kind of waiting for somebody to go, hey, you
know, but is that going to happen?
But, it's not gonna happen. You know.
That word was.
Pause. Timeout. 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 I mean.
That went up to 10 all the way.
Right? I mean, wow. I mean, I don't. Do I need to run it back? Because I'm pretty sure he did say that, what I think he said. My guy looks like Steve Carell. Can we just, like, note that?
Oh, wow, I mean, yeah, he does.
What happened between Bruno
Steve,
and myself
Steve Carell's
was
most
really
challenging role.
You have these judgments that I think you have no right to have. I knew we had differences
totally
going into the project. I didn't know how great those differences were.
What are you going to do about it?
I don't know how we're going to make it.
We did something
buckle
no
up,
one else
buckaroos,
has ever done.
It's about to get cringy. Like
Brian, right? I'm 40, and yeah, I'm going to become a white man.
Still amazed at all these colors making me white.
I see browns and blues and greens and reds, but the finished product.
I see skies of blue.
I look like a white guy.
I'm Nick, and I'm 16, and I'm going to be transformed into a white dude.
My name is Renee, and by changing the color of my skin, I will be able to see what it's like to be white.
The white family are called the Wurgles, but they might as well be called the Whites. They are just the whitest people in America.
Hello, girl.
Yeah, see, she looks like the last fresh prince of Bel Air, like Ashley.
I'm like,
I think.
I'm white.
Do you know what I mean?
A former.
I haven't seen that.
There's no doubt about it.
Steve Carell in the new movie, in the remake of Soul Man.
Blacks are superior.
We might have to watch Soul Man at some point.
You know, physically, awesome.
He does look like a white guy.
He does look like a white guy as well.
To imagine what it's gonna look like.
Oh, look as white as you.
Yeah. Look at that.
They look like the whitest couple ever.
Be laughing at you the wrong way because remember we're in makeup. But I mean, you don't look anything like a guy that I would be anywhere attracted to.
Come on, white girl. Come on, white girl.
I don't want to.
Come on, white girl.
Just. Oh my God, that is so strange. Oh my God.
Wow, creepy face.
Right? I mean,
who's that? His daughter he's looking at?
What? Dude. Steady.
Well, he's the one making the face.
I mean, of all the places I could have paused it.
No.
Alright.
Ah, it's just really beautiful. That's just like I'm in love with this woman. It's beautiful.
Okay, so when do we get to.
Can we just take a second to appreciate that lovely cringy moment? Oh, that was the good stuff.
see Nick, because so, now I'm really curious.
Embrace the cringe.
What?
Heats now, wow. See. I mean, he's straight out of High School Musical. He's like Zac Efron meets, like, kid from Stranger Things. I mean.
Wow. All right. Wow. You look good.
Shopping for clubs. So he's interested to see what kind of clubs you're using.
Yeah, I have these custom made at some little shop down in Burbank.
Oh, okay. I feel very accepted as if I was one of their own. Appreciate your time. Your name?
I'm John.
John Brian White.
Brian White. I mean, they kind of did the thing that I said.
Right?
People were talking to me like, my sister.
See, Lee was trying to holler.
What?
Holler means he's trying to go out with you.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he was liking you.
I needed a pair of shoes, so I went shopping. As a white guy, I'm relaxed when I'm shopping. I put on my white makeup and I'm having fun. And then the most amazing thing happened. The guy actually took my foot and put it in the shoe and put a shoehorn in the back to make sure my foot slide in.
My man needs to get out more.
That feels good.
Right?
This kind of shoe should be pretty comfortable right from the start. Mm-hmm.
I have never in my life had someone, you know, they come out and give me my shoe. But I've never had anyone actually unlace it, open it, shoehorn the back, and slide my foot into the shoe. Is this what the white guy...
And from that moment on, he discovered something he never knew about himself.
Get this all the benefits of
getting shoehorns? Or...
Never happened to be black in 40 years.
Having
the
shoes put on.
The first time I go and buy shoes as maybe. White, I haven't done. I was like, wow, the possibilities are endless.
I had a broken wrist.
Over the next several weeks, my family's gonna be living.
Yeah, and Mr. Ediger, the PE teacher, he always offered to like help me with stuff in the bathroom. Mr. Ediger, yes. Fucking, oh, pardon me. That man should not have been a teacher.
Here, let me help you with that, Josh.
Right.
I'll have the.
There were probably he probably had cameras like all up in there.
Oh Lord above.
Opportunity
probably
to
not,
discuss
kidding,
the experiences.
They weren't as cheap back then.
F in chat for Mr. Eric, huh?
Lock on the door, we don't want the black people stealing anything.
Time out. What? I mean... That didn't
what
age well.
Channel did this air on, and when? How long ago was it?
FX. I think it was 2008.
Oh wow. Okay. Oh, dear. FX right there.
My mom and Bruno don't exactly spend a lot of time with black
but
people.
But he did actually just
so
say that.
I think
that.
I'm a little nervous that they might say
that
the
was
wrong
a thing,
thing
that he said.
First thing we had to do yeah. was teach each other how.
And trust me, it's the first of many things he's gonna say.
Black.
Yeah.
I was figuring I would walk in and just basically high five everybody.
Oh hell no. Oh hell no.
High five everybody.
You know, I know how to communicate with them to get what I want.
We interact with whites daily. Black culture has to conform to white society to make it.
Yeah. It's gonna be fun.
It's gonna be fun.
It's gonna be fun.
Yeah.
We are in for something. We are in
See,
for something.
It's hard to know whether that was just edited, so it looked like the black dad talking about his struggle and then the white guy saying, oh yeah, that'd be fun. It sort of makes you wonder if they actually made that decision to sort of cut that like that, or whether he
they
literally just
did.
Said... Yeah, it kind of felt like that, didn't it? But
every
yeah.
show is fake.
Well, yeah.
Even like the most real show, it's bullshit.
That's it.
Right. To some degree.
But I think, not to spoil anything, but Bruno, the white dad, is possibly crass enough to do that, actually, and for that to have been real.
I'll get some attitude from some prick white guy, and I won't have all the history of resentment
right.
that a black man has, and I'll be able to f*** with them. Oh, just, you know, mentally spar with them and go,
like,
you know, he says, hey, Nick, you know, I won't get angry. I'll just kind of smile to myself and go, wow, why'd you say that?
When I hear the N-word.
The daughter's like, holy shit.
Yeah, that was like Hiroshima, man. That was like, boom.
My jaws clench up. It resonates with me, and I know it's just a word, but, you know, what I had to go through growing up, that word still gets me. It's powerful.
What if we're at a gathering, all of us are having dinner together, and there are pretty much equal blacks and whites, and then the whites leave and y'all start jiving? No. Jiving?
See, that's white.
Right. Driving.
And y'all start driving?
When y'all start jiving.
Oh.
Jive talking.
Driving.
Jiving, yeah. Wow.
Because the black... Because the white people are gone, or...?
No, because she's like, y'all are jiving, and like... I mean, she's sort of adopting the lingo, and I mean, cringe.
That's very white.
Is it really?
No, get down, mama. That's a pass the grits and chicken. That's a job.
It was scary.
It was.
No,
great.
That definitely looks like makeup.
I knew
that
Brian was behind the two-way mirror.
Yeah. He definitely looks like Steve Carell too.
And he gave me some advice on how to be black. He told me to sort of just kick back. Don't have great posture. Lean to one side and sort of slouch in the chair.
I was mindful of not being overly inquisitive.
What do you see today as the biggest difference between being black and white in America?
When I think of white people, I think ethnocentric. Very much like my way of seeing things is the best, most correct way. And anything that's different than that, you know, I don't want to get to know.
Yeah.
It's assimilation. You know, it's kind of like as long as we assimilate and do what.
And I mean, it ties back to what I was saying earlier, man, that, like, we get stuck in these mindsets, you know? People adopt these attitudes and they don't give them up. I mean, if shown people are not prepared to accept anybody else's opinion. And, you know, that's kind of holding us back.
But they do, we're okay. But if we're kind of like off on the side doing our own little thing, you might be a little bit intimidated.
Seems like that's just the way it is. This world is dominated by white people, and I don't think it's any way that we'll ever be considered equal.
Because they just talk at you anyway.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a grown man, he'd be having them talk, hey, get over there, hey, get this, pick that up, hey, get over here, you know? It's like, wait, I'm a man. They don't even talk to their kids like that.
There's a world there that I got to have an eye-opening view of. It was pretty amazing and very enlightening to experience just a taste of what it's like for the black world.
You know, there's a lot of controversy about the N-word and who can use it or whether it should be used at all. Who has experienced an intentional attempt to disrespect you by using that term? That's what I'm trying to get at.
Oh, yeah.
Have you had experiences like that?
Yeah, I used to work as a doorman at a disco. You know, and if somebody came up intoxicated or didn't have the...
Bruno, mate, I don't think that was your turn to speak. I think that was other people's turn to speak. They might have, again, just edited it to that, but yeah, no.
Right.
You're not in a position to have this talk that you're having now, mate. Serious.
The right dress on, you know, just say, come on, mate.
Well, yeah, sure, Bruno. Nice, mate.
Yeah, I'm a lot more hostile than that. Now, just, you know, yeah, that's right, I'm there. You know, it just wouldn't affect me. And that would be the...
I mean, that guy there says it all.
These guys are not buying it.
End of the conflict, just like that. Because I wouldn't give it the power.
The only reason why people call you derogatory names is so that they can inflame you. If you don't empower the people that call you the N-word by getting upset, you win. And the idiot that just called you that doesn't have any power.
Right.
My man.
Note that, because that's like one of the few times that he's actually going to be right about something.
Main thing is just to be the fly on the wall and see how whites act when blacks are nowhere around.
I'll be able to, you know, actually hear what they say when I'm not in the room. But I'll actually be in the room.
She's walking like a white woman.
Fixing things with my hand.
My name is Renee, and
my hobbies, swimming, tennis, shop.
Do you think you'd notice? Obviously, we're watching this, we know, but do you think if you were in a live situation, you would notice there was something off about how this person looked?
I don't know, probably not.
I mean,
because I've seen, like, I live in a, like, it's pretty diverse here, and yeah, I mean, I don't think I'd be able to tell.
I mean, we're clued in.
You see all sorts of people here, so.
We know what the truth is, but if it came down to it, I'm not entirely sure I would. I would, the white dressed as black, because that's just standout. I mean, that's
I'd
just,
probably, like, think
clear
that they
day.
Have, like, a really distinguished face, though.
Yeah, well, see,
like, not like
with the black folks, I would. That's where I wouldn't be able to tell, but I would know. I'd probably notice there wasn't something. Like there was something unusual about their face, like you say, for sure.
Right.
But the white folks, I would definitely, blacked up. That's a white guy in blackface is frippin' a white guy in blackface. But yeah, this is a lot more subtle and
racism.
I don't know if I
still
would.
In today.
I don't know if I would notice. I don't know if I,
A society.
Yeah, it's hard to say.
Know, I want to think that everybody is treated equally, and you know what? They're not.
You're so bad. It had nothing to do with the color of her complexion. Whatever I would have to document to fire her, I'd have to have an even longer list to make sure that we're not sued.
Yeah, I've been there.
Yeah. Yes.
Right, now, I suspect this woman here is a plant.
There's a black guy behind the counter.
She's a stooge. She's been put there to sort of put the cat amongst the pigeons by the producers or whoever.
And my friend tipped him and said, put a tip in the jar and said, thank you, brother. And the guy said, watch how you say that.
Only black people can call themselves brother or even the N-word.
I don't look at a black person and say, I want to do harm. And sometimes there's these innate things that I think have been taught that, I shake someone's hand that's black and my instinct is to wipe it or something. I'm very...
Right?
I don't think so. That's not...
Yeah, no.
Not accurate.
I'm not racist, but it was very much that, wasn't it? It was like,
Don't take this the wrong way, with all due respect. Please
but
don't be offended
I've
by this.
I've really got to wash my hand now, because I feel like I'm going to probably start turning black if I don't. And
right.
That would probably be the worst thing that could ever happen to me. That's the vibes I got from that.
Very conscious
right.
of it.
No, I lived in a pretty hick-ass place where I grew up, and I guess people were racist there, but I never... Some people were racist, but the kids weren't racist.
When I was a kid, I was a horrible little racist, but that's because my dad was. But then I grew out of it, because racism's just bullshit, man. We're all the fucking same. I don't care what anybody, nobody could convince me otherwise. I know I said about, but that's fundamental. That's a core belief of mine, that we're all the same. Talking to people on Omegle's taught me that way. It doesn't matter where we're from, we're all the same. Racism is bullshit.
Those focus groups were really eye-opening.
I look forward to having someone say, hey, Nick, you're a son of a bitch. I hate you, Nick.
It's like really using that thing.
He's getting as much mileage as he can out of it.
They get all freaked out about it, and I just look at him and go, gee, why did you call me that? And that would be the end of it.
When we were in the focus group,
it was interesting that out of the whole group, Bruno used the word nigger.
With the ER? Yeah.
He was the first one to say.
They like that word.
They like.
I mean, man, I'm cringing so hard right now.
It for some reason. I don't know why.
Like when you're black, it's okay for you to say the word then, but when you're white, just.
I think that most white people, not all, would love to say nigga in the presence of black and not have any repercussions.